Very good morning to all my dear students. Once again, welcome you all to your class of English. In the previous class, we have discussed about the diary of Anne Frank. I have already told you that the diary of Anne Frank is an autobiographical sketch of Anne Frank's life herself. It is not a fictional or an imaginary story, but it's a diary where she noted down or she gave an account of her life and the surroundings that happened at the time. So today I just want to discuss something more about the same, the diary of Anne Frank. The diary was originally written in Dutch language and it became one of the world's most widely read books. Many films, television and theatrical productions and an opera have been based on the diary. Anne Frank has become one of the most famous and talked about Holocaust victims. When she started writing down the diary, she was of the view that no one would be interested in the musings of 13-year-old girl. When the diary was gifted to her by her parents, she was 13 years old and she was in a confusion that if she would start writing down the diary, then no one would be interested in the musings, in the thoughts of 13-year-old girl. But eventually she had no best friend with whom she can confide in and share her inner feelings and emotions, and that's why she thought and she started writing down the diary. When she started writing down the diary, she gave a brief account of her family, her background, so that it would become easy for the readers to understand when they will read the diary one day or the other. So when she started writing down the diary, she noted that paper has more patience than people. She thought of this saying on one of those days when she was feeling a little depressed and she was sitting at home with the chin in her hands. And she was very listless, very hopeless, wondering whether to stay in or go out, as they had to hide themselves due to the Nazi occupations, and they were in the hidden, and she was in a dilemma because internally she didn't want to stay in, but forcefully she had to be there for the whole day. Finally, she stayed there and she was thinking over and she started writing down the diary. And when she started writing the diary, she gave a brief account of her family and referred the diary in a stiff back notebook. Unless she could find a real friend, she probably made diary her best friend. And she gave an account of family, that she had loving parents and a 16-year-old sister, Margot. And there are 30 other people in her family to whom they call friends. But she had loving aunts and a very good home. And to enhance the image of this long-awaited friend in her imagination, she don't want to jot down the facts in the diary the way most people would do. But she wanted to diary become her friend, and she was going to call her friend a kitty. And she gave an account of her father, that her father was the most adorable father that she have ever seen, and who married her mother when he was 25, and they both lived in Germany in Frankfurt, and she was born on June 12, 1929. And when she gave an account of her class, of her school, when she was in 6th grade, the teacher was Mrs. Cooperis. She was also the headmistress, the principal of the school. At the end of the year, they both were in the tears, as she said she had a heartbreaking farewell because she had a very great emotional attachment with her teacher. In the summer of 1941, her grandmother fell ill and had to have an operation, so her birthday was not celebrated on a grand scale. The reason, of course, is the forthcoming meeting in the teachers. And now she gave an account of her school life when most of the students were awaiting about the result. And most of the teachers were in a view that what will happen, and they have to decide that who will be promoted to the next class. And most of the students were making bets on this, that who will be promoted and who will not be. So there are two students in Anne's class who were requesting and making bets, and all the time they continuously talked about that whether they will pass or not, and they had the bets on the same issue. And even Anne's friends, GS pleadings, requesting, and Anne's angry outbursts didn't have any impact on them. And but they all the time talked about the results of their upcoming exams. And what they discussed about, they said that teachers are the most unpredictable creatures on the earth, so no one knows that what will happen in the forthcoming result. And as she gave an account of her maths teacher, Mr. Kissing, who was very annoyed with Anne all the time because of her habit of talking too much. And one day he gave an assignment to Anne to write down an essay on the topic chatterbox. As she was talking too much in the class, so as a punishment, as a penalty, he gave her an essay to write down. And while when she writes down the essay, she gave very logical reasons, very convincing statements, so that the teacher may understand that it is her inherited trait or the feature that she has acquired from her mother, so she can't resist talking. But the teacher didn't understand, and the next time he gave an essay to write down on the incorrigible chatterbox, and the next time on the topic quack quack quack. And but ultimately Mr. Kissing understood her point when she took the help of her friend Sane in writing down that quack quack topic in the form of poetry. And ultimately the teacher understood her point of view and just be normal with the Anne Frank. So that's what that Anne gave an account of her diary. So right now I'm going to share our YouTube link so that you can have word to word and sentence to sentence reading of this chapter, as there are few words, few phrases that you must know, like chest off and other few phrases that you must go through while you will read out the chapter. So here on the YouTube link, all the meaning of the difficult and new phrases have been given. So kindly go through and complete the assignment which I'm going to share you with right now. Thank you so much.